Well, thank you. So I'll talk a little bit more about the application of music, and more specifically with regard to trauma, because I'm doing a PTSD project on the impact of music on sleep. And here I'll tell you music as a tool for improving sleep in post-traumatic stress disorder. And first I'll give you a little bit of background, and then I'll present a study that we did with traumatized refugees and draw some conclusions from that. But first about sleep. It is a fundamental biological need for all living beings. And as human beings, we actually sleep around one-third of our lives. So that's, in a norm average lifetime, that's quite a lot of years, maybe 25 or even 30 years. So there's plenty of reasons to be interested in sleep. Nevertheless, sleep problems are highly prevalent in modern society, with around one-third of the general population experiencing insomnia symptoms, such as difficulties falling asleep, or frequent awakenings during the night, or early morning awakenings, or non-restorative sleep. And persisting sleep problems can have a negative impact on very important aspects of our functioning, such as cognitive abilities, with the impaired memory function, attention, and concentration, which can be quite serious. For instance, a relationship has been found between lack of sleep and an increased risk of accidents, both work-related and traffic accidents. And emotional aspects are also affected by lack of sleep, with consequences for your mood, dysphoria, or increased irritability, as many of us may have experienced. Sleep is also related to general health, and studies show that lack of sleep results in impaired immune system functioning. And sleep disorders are related to a number of diseases, such as diabetes, neurological disorders, chronic pain, and cardiovascular disorders, and also a number of psychiatric diseases. And this leads us to the relationship between trauma and sleep, because sleep can be severely disrupted following exposure to traumatic events, and especially the experience of nightmares is frequent. And some researchers even call sleep disturbances the hallmark of post-traumatic stress disorder. So this close relationship is also related, or is also reflected in the fact that sleep disorders are mentioned in the diagnosis of post-traumatic stress disorder, nightmares in the intrusive or re-experiencing clusters, and insomnia symptoms in the hyperarousal cluster. And more than two-thirds of persons with post-traumatic stress disorder experience sleep disturbances. And furthermore, a relationship between impaired sleep and the severity of the sleep of the PTSD symptoms have been found. So it is quite an important aspect. Also, some studies have found that sleep disturbances may be an early predictor of the development of PTSD. In a study with traffic accidents, they found that the persons experiencing sleep disturbances 1 month after the accident had a significantly higher risk of having developed PTSD 1 year after the accident compared to the group of people who did not have sleep disturbances 1 year after the accident. So attention to sleep problems in relation to trauma is quite important. And it has also been argued that a focus on sleep problems should be incorporated into treatments of post-traumatic stress disorder. So when talking about how to target or how to work with sleep problems in relation to trauma, why look at music? It seems that there is some kind of common sense connection between music and sleep, as witnessed by the music genre of lullabies, for instance, with the parents all over the world singing for their children to calm them and make them fall asleep. But also, as Nigel mentioned, there is a clear connection between music and physiological arousal, which has been documented in numerous studies. And this is just to give you an example. in this study by Bernardi and his colleagues, they organized the music of different genres, but they organized it by tempo, and they found a clear relationship between the musical tempo and a heart rate measure reflecting arousal. And this is one of the most consistent findings with regard to music. And with sleep problems in relation to trauma, this, as we saw in the diagnostic criteria of PTSD diagnosis, this is quite important because hyperarousal is one of the core features of post-traumatic stress disorder. Another aspect that points to the relevance of music is the ability of music to distract our attention, that music can attract attention. And as we saw in one of the other core features of post-traumatic stress disorder, the intruding thoughts or memories or re-experiencing symptoms sustain a high level of anxiety, or and if we can introduce a stimulus like music that is either neutral or maybe even pleasant, as Morten talked about, this may be relevant for sleep and sleep quality and the ability to actually fall asleep. And Finally, just like also Morten and Nigel mentioned, the impact of music on emotion is also very well documented. And music can both induce positive emotional states, but also reduce negative emotional states. And these are just a result from a very recent randomized control trials with severely ill persons, critically ill, admitted to intensive care unit. And they had three conditions. One group of people listened to music. Another group of people had noise-reducing headphones. And the last group had care as usual. And there was a clear effect of the music on anxiety. There was a clear reduction of anxiety during the days the persons were admitted, but no change in the other groups. So, it seems relevant to study the impact of music and sleep. And this has been done for the last 20 years. Not many studies, but a few. And these are not all, but just to give you a short impression of the control trials in this field. And as you can see, various populations have been studied with different kinds of music and also with different designs and intervention periods. But in general, the studies find a positive effect of the music on sleep quality. But the effect of music on sleep quality in traumatized person had not been studied. And at this time, I was working with traumatized refugees. So from a clinical perspective, I also found it highly relevant to see, okay, is this a tool that we can use?